To Ring of Valor, Season 2, Episode Number 11. Next week will be the Go Home Show. I am your host, the new boy, and I'm thank you guys. Hope you're doing well. If you'd like to give me a follow on Twitch, that would be much appreciative. Currently we have 232 followers, and I'm appreciative of everyone. All streams and chats are interactive, so please participate if you can. If you can't, that is fine. All streams are exclusive to Twitch for one day. We have a opening promo, self-promotion from Odie Murray, who is on excursion from another promotion. And the matches we have is Ace Austin and Jordan Oliver, then we have Billy Kay going against the Saint. Then we have Boyd going up against Biff Music. The co-main event is former Queen of Valor champion Firebrand going up against Carmella with her manager R-Truth. And the main event is a rivalry match. Bianca Belair going up against Asuka with her manager Kairi Sane. So let's welcome everyone and let's see where we are this week. My YouTube channel is youtube.com Hammers Reviews. Remember people to spend your Twitch points, but channel redemption points. So my drink of choice today is strawberry and banana, G Fuel, and Bobby Boy Senberry, which is grape flavor G Fuel. Ring of Valor Universe, let's see where we are this week. We are in Niigata, Japan. I will support any content creators, big or small, it don't matter to me. I will help anyone out. If you would like to support me on the channel, my Patreon is patreon.com, Hammers Reviews. If you don't have a Patreon, I have a donation button on my Twitch page. If you'd like to follow my Facebook fan pages, they are Facebook, Blueboy1995 Streams. Welcome, Baldboy1997. Hope you're doing well, buddy. And my other Facebooks are Facebook Hammers Reviews, Facebook Hammers Reviews Stream, and Facebook Hammers Reviews Streams. If you'd like to follow my other social media, like my Instagram and Twitter, we have some rules. No prostitutes, no gaming girls, no trying to chat me up because I'm happily engaged, so stop it. It's for business, networking, collaboration, and anything you want to. Welcome to anyone else that has just joined the stream. So let's go. Odin Murray was a bodyguard for a Black Label Society style band. Okay, I'll try Border Warriors 1987. Welcome anyone that has just joined the stream. My Instagram is Instagram at HammersReviews1 and my Twitters are Twitter at BlueBoy85 and BlueBoy1985.com. So without further ado, let's get started. I don't know why Visual Concepts have blurred out the word Odin Murray. P2 played Pokemon. Thank you very much for the subscribe on my YouTube. Thank you very much. Much appreciated. I just gotta get my Discord link for people to join if they're interested. It's Visual Concepts. I'm more pissed with not 2K, but 2K have to do what their bosses tell them to do. The Discord is fun, so please join if you can. Let's go. Odin Murray will be making his debut. He's heading from Reykjavik, Iceland. He hopefully will be making his debut at the Go Home episode or the season finale. I haven't decided yet. Let's see what Mr. Murray's. Murray's a Scandinavian word for sailor. So I don't know why the fucking blurted that one out of the dicks. I wish I could see. I was coming out here tonight under better circumstances, but that sadly not the case. It's no secret why I'm not in a good mood tonight. So enough stalling. Let's get into it. They say anything can happen in the ROV, but when was the last time anything really happened? I can't remember, and it seems like you can't either. That's why it's time for me to take the bull by the horns and make something happen. I'm not waiting another damn minute for it. Odin, control your beard, sir. I'm really lucky and fortunate to be out here every day in this ring doing what I love, and I want to do more. I can't get enough of being in the ring. It gives me life. From now on, if anyone gets in my way, if anyone wrongs me, they're going to see a different side of me, an uglier side, a side that doesn't lay down for anyone and won't let any personal injustice stand. Okay, Mr. Murray, mince. So now it's about time I go in the back and bake bread. My best friends are there, my rivals are there, but I'm hungry. Hungry hippo. hungry Norsk. That was very passionate for my former Odin Murray. He will be I'm not sure who his opponent should be. Who do you think Odin's first opponent should be, ladies and gents? Let me know in the chat section below. So I can actually open up my notepad so I can put out ideas. This should be a very interesting match. So next leg up, we'll see if the entrances are off. Yep, they're all off. The co-main event and main event, let's turn to slow momentum and all that jazz. Hailing from Atlantic City, New Jersey. That's where the casinos are in New Jersey. Ace Austin and his opponent hailing from New York. Future legend Jordan Oliver. Is everyone's Twitch being playing up, or is it just mine? I think both have a bright future. Spinner will make the deal. Before we actually do season three of this new universe, all brands will be having a draft of some kind. Ah, God damn it, 2 seconds. I've just gotta open the Discord. Every 2 seconds, I just need to get on the Discord. If anyone would like to join the Discord, please do. Seconds. I'll just give you a. I'll have to find. Group Discord, where the fuck is it? It's not wanting to show up today. Good afternoon. Hello mate, you're right. Yeah, not too bad.
That's cool. I'm just turning the telly down so it don't echo.
That's fine, buddy. How are you today?
Very much, very well, mate. Yeah, I was impressed with Odin's promo.
2 seconds. I've got to turn my mic down. I'm just thinking a bit. The referee wants a good clean fight. Who do you think is going to win, everyone? Is it going to be Jordan Oliver or Ace Austin?
Definitely Jordan Oliver. He impresses the hell out of me.
He's currently in MLW with a guy called Myron Reed as Injustice.
Yeah.
And I have seen him in a place like CZW Beyond Wrestling. Jordan Oliver stamping the piss out of Ace Austin, who is currently the X Division champion. Nice star move from Jordan Oliver. Hello? 2 seconds, I'll have to call you back. What happened there? Oh, bollocks. The disc has been a slippery devil today, so. Nice discus, Lariato. Seconds. What happened there?
Hello?
Hello, mate. Yeah, what happened there?
I don't know. It just cut off.
Nice. Northern Light Suplex. Only enough for the one count.
That's a nice connection, like, with that suplex as well.
Absolutely, yeah. Nice super kick. To anyone that is a wrestling fan, I have a question. Who was the first wrestler to use a super kick? Was it Gentleman Chris Adams or Shawn Michaels?
I believe it was Gentleman Chris Adams.
Okay, which promotion? Do you know which promotion he debuted at?
I think it was the Von Erich territory, WCCW.
It was, yep, pretty much. He's a guy that is no longer with us. Nice kick to the lumbar, which is a smaller portion of your spine and back.
I believe he trained Stone Cold.
That is also correct. Nice go to sleep front.
Hello, Miranda 1935.
Welcome, Miranda 1935. Nice go to sleep style move from Ace Austin.
That'd be a super show I'd love to, like, organise with you and ROV versus NSW co-promotion.
Probably, but probably not yet. Nice. Hurricane Runner from Ace Austin.
Can you hear me, Miranda 1935?
Nice drop from Ace Austin. Nice snapmare suplex. Followed by the dropkick to the back of Jordan Oliver. No, Ace Austin. Jordan Oliver going for a Stars Clash style maneuver. But don't capitalise.
Oh, thanks, Miranda.
Nice Irish whip to the outside from Jordan Oliver onto Ace Austin. Jordan Oliver throws Ace Austin back into the ring. Nice C4 Spanish fly from Jordan Oliver. One, two, only enough for two. A fun fact about the C4 or Spanish fly, the first time I saw a stereo version was in Ring of Honor, like the Spanish announced him, Jose and Joel Maximo, which are cousins of the Amazing Red. They did it in on the top rope, a super Spanish fly, and I was like, shit, it's the first time I actually saw it.
Did Paul Virtue use that,
when he was the pirate gimmick. Nice kick to the midsection, nice sunset flip powerbomb. Is it enough for the win? Oh, for Jordan Oliver to capitalize. Nice body splash from Jordan Oliver. But doesn't go for the pin. Nice low super kick. Nice shining wizard from Jordan Oliver. Nice. Release sunset flip powerbomb. Jordan Oliver needs to go for the pin.
He's wasting a lot of time.
Yeah, showboating to the crowd. Too much.
Yeah, just finish it, goddammit.
Please hold on to you. Nice arm drag from Ace Austin. Nice elbow strike. Nice spike, Hurricane Runner. You've got to tuck your head in when you do things like that star move, because if you don't, you could potentially break your neck.
Or
a stinger, it all depends. Go for the pin. One, Only not 41 pounds. Oh, this is strange.
I'll tell you one move I hate that I hate taking, because I always get the elevation wrong. I don't take the back body drop.
Yeah, that is a nightmare. Nice knees from Ace Austin. Ace Austin going to the top rope.
A lot of the boys say, don't worry about back body drops. They're optional. You don't have to do them.
Nice. Moonsault. Nice twisting moonsault. Nice body splash. But does he have enough in his tank? He doesn't capitalize.
Ace Austin's going all out so far.
Yeah, Ace Austin, is he going for the W? 1, 2. Only enough for a 2 count still. Something's got to give in this match. It's been even Steven so far.
I already rate it a 5-star if I was Dave
Meltzer. Oh, I fucking hate that guy. So how can you give something infinity fucking stars? Oh, that fucking clown Forby, he needs to get his ass smoked. Absolutely, this is awesome. Nice running. Dropkick to the temple, the side of the head. Jordan Oliver's been busted open, donning the proverbial crimson mask. And that is enough for Jordan Oliver. No, Ace Austin. Came back from behind to pick up the W, so hopefully he goes up in the ranking system.
What promotions does he work for, dudes?
Impact, because he's the X Division champion, and some other promotion. I can't think. I'll have to have a look. Yeah, Mr. Fogg's a douchebag. I don't like the guy.
He hasn't been coming up bothering me, which is good.
Yeah. Thank fuck for that. Let's see what the next match is.
The good thing is, it recognised him. He's a championship contender.
Yeah. I think that has bumped him up quite a bit then.
As you say, when it works, it's fine.
Yeah. Hailing from Melbourne, Australia. With her manager, also heading from Melbourne, Australia. Manager Peyton Royce with her client, Billy Kay, the former Iconics. And her opponent, hailing from Durango, Mexico. Sister of the Blue Saint. The Blue Saint and the Red Saint are on excursion currently, so they'll be back very soon. I don't know when, but it will be down the line somewhere.
They are in safe hands with me, by the way.
Yeah. Bald Warrior 1987 is a very good content creator. The Saint, the Blue Saint, the Red Saint and Saint 2 are my creations. My inspiration for the characters like the Blue Saint was Santos, the famous luchador from all those years ago, and Blue Demon Jr. Nice bridge in Northern Light Suplex from Billy Kay. I think Billy Kay and Peyton Royce, I think their accents are a bit put on. Nice high angle Saito Suplex, made very famous by Masao Saito, former Japanese wrestler and referee. You may have seen him in WCW.
If you want me to be honest, dudes, I think Peyton Royce and Billy Kay, I'd say Peyton's definitely like the HBK of the two, and I'd say Billy Kay's more like the Jannetty.
Possibly. Nice wrist lock. Torture rack. Bald Warriors, details are twitch.tv Bald Warrior 1987, and his YouTube channel, if anyone is interested, is WrestleBlogger 1987 is where you basically, if you have missed the stream, it will basically, his content will be on the YouTube channel afterwards, after it's been exported. But I have, because I'm affiliated, I have to wait a day. So what do you think of the show so far, Bald Warrior? No, sit down, Spinebuster, from...
Very well, very well, very well booked, mate.
Nice, hair pull slam. I will let people book a match for the Go Home show next week, so nice crucifix.
I'd see what I'd love to see, mate. Maybe for the Co, if that's alright. Maybe do Leo Rush, Champagne Charlie thing, book out anywhere.
Possibly. I think we're going to have a stacked card next week. That may be the issue. I may do that for the season finale.
Are you thinking of turning the Russian Champagne Charlie into a bit of a fuse?
If I can. Oh, yeah. Oh, that's bloody good news. The person that ended up, the police person in Shuby Park, has been arrested. About fucking time. Good flipping one. Only enough for a one. Billy Kay was a bit too close to the ropes. I think really.
At least that time he didn't glitch out, because you really got annoyed with the whole Kevin Owens thing, saying as he was on the fucking ropes.
Yeah, assholes. Peyton Royce, causing distraction. I think Rhea Ripley's Australian accent's more authentic than certain other two. Nice.
And Rhea Ripley can cut a decent promo.
Yeah. 1, 2, 3, and your winner with the overhead T-bone suplex, the Saint.
She'll definitely be bumped up, I reckon, the Saint. She performed really well.
I think she may be the number one contender, but I'm not sure. Remember, people, to use your channel points.
You still hear me, mate?
Yep. We've got a shorter match card this week. Hailing from Reno, Nevada, which is on the outskirts of Las Vegas. Representing one third of the Dark Elemental Brothers, Void. And his opponent, hailing from Boston, Massachusetts, better known now as Oney Lorcan. His original name is Biff Fulick, and he wrestled for Beyond Wrestling, and he was a CZW World Champion.
Are him and Danny Burch the tag team champions?
They were, but they've held the titles up because Martin Stone has been injured.
He's a great guy, he's Danny Burch, aka Martin Stone.
Yeah, I remember seeing him at an IPW UK show. That show was bloody awesome. So who do you think's going to win, people?
I'm going to go with your character, Voice.
Nice, clubbing blow. I have given him Scott Hall's moves, better known as Razor Ramon, to people that know wrestling.
He's definitely got a Papa Shenko size for him.
Yeah, that was one of the ideas. I was actually supposed, it was supposed to be a black metal band, but I thought, no.
My idea. Kind of looks a little bit like Sting as well.
Yeah. I've been a wrestling fan for 33 years. I'm 36 now, so most people grew out of wrestling, but I never did. Some things really do upset me about fans sometimes. They should stop fucking stalking wrestlers.
Yeah, the whole speaking out movement's fucked the business.
Yeah, because, you know, I think Mighty Skrull was set up by Daniel Edler. because he was basically buying the young girl drinks. That's Daniel Erdler, because we know what that fucker's all about, don't we?
Creepy bastards.
Yeah, and some other fuckers. But we won't go into those fucking arseholes.
I remember, well, you know, I was watching that IPW show earlier. I remember when, like, Corey Graves was tag team partners with Abyss.
Oh, yeah, 1BW, yeah.
Yeah.
So, if he hits into the wall, void, or the Void Walker's edge, then it's game over. Nice slingshot. Neck first, or larynx first.
He's got the same sort of height as Scott Hall as well.
Nice abdominal stretch. Scott Hall has Razor Ramon debuted in 1992. Fun fact about Scott Hall, he was never actually in the Royal Rumble match due to being in title matches.
The fake Razor Ramon, however, doesn't count because he was in the Rumble.
Okay, who was the fake Razor Ramon, if you know offhand?
Rick Bognar, aka Rick Titan.
Yep, that's the one. I think Rick Titan does films these days because he should have. They should have really given him a fucking chance.
Well, wait a minute, I think he passed away.
I'm not. I know someone passed away. Way in wrestling recently, but I cannot think who it was. Oh yeah, Jim Crockett Jr. Nice. Into the Void chokeslam from Void. If he hits the Void Walker's edge, then it's game over, Mr. Busick. Go for the pin. 1, 2, 3. And he didn't have to use his finisher this week. Because what?
Is the chokeslam basically the signature?
Yeah, the chokeslam is his signature, and the crucifix powerbomb, like the Razor's Edge, I call it the Void Walker's Edge, so that's all good.
Traditionally then, it's a signature, normally the setup move to the finisher.
Yeah, sometimes, but it doesn't always work, but this has been behaving itself.
Writing that stream you did earlier off there, mate, pretending it never happens.
Yeah, probably won't upload it to YouTube. So how is everyone doing? Hailing from Perth, Western Australia, former Queen of Valor, Women's Champion, Firebrand, representing the Elemental Sisters. And hailing from Staten Island, New York, Carmella with her manager. Hailing from Charlotte, North Carolina, or the South Carolina. No, it's one of the two.
Miranda 1935, Mr. Full Burrs. He's taking the piss a little bit because he used the downstairs shower to shower, and he's not supposed to. That's only for the hairdresser that comes to do people's hair.
Oh, Christ. Carmella's father is called Paul Vandale. He was enhancement for the WWF years ago. Yes, I said WWF. That's what it was at the time, so.
And being the traditionalist in Makers, obviously I've been a fan just as long as people know any faith. WWF will always be what I'll call it as well, because that's the era, that was the cool era.
But nowadays it's gone to complete arse.
Back when it weren't all about the flips, it was all about the big moves.
This is the co-main event of the evening. Nice drift, Rose Slam from Fire.
Yeah, if I may, mate, I'll say this. Nowadays, you've got to be a flippy person to do wrestling.
Yeah, basically. I'm not saying certain people I don't like from the DKW or something. Taylor Essex, he's a bit of an arse hat. One, two, he's the biggest arse hat. Yeah, so what's wrong with his shower in his, like, in his room?
He just can't be arsed. He just thinks going downstairs he's entitled to use it.
No, it should, what it should be, say for example, someone's disabled and it's been modified, then yes, but he ain't fucking disabled, he's a fucking asshole.
He ain't getting away with it, mate. I'm grassing him up to Karen.
Yeah, nice. Fisherman Buster from Firebrand. Only enough for a one count. It's not that. It's not right, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah, don't do him. Just say, well, basically, he's taking the Michael. 34. Thank you very much for the follow, much appreciated.
It's unfair on the girls that want to watch the telly in that room as well.
I sure can. I can create anyone, just tell me exactly the diameters, what kind of couch you like, and I will create anyone.
I predict your character for the win.
Yeah, knowing that she has been. Yep, you can be. You can be any character. Say you want to be a luchador. Just tell me what kind of, like, height, weight department. Nice. Float over, butterfly suplex.
Is Big Money Dylan still like talk to you, mate?
I haven't seen him in a few days. He did nice springboard lariat. It's similar to Adam Hangman Page's buckshot lariat. And your winner of the co-main event, Firebrand. Yep, that can be done.
I'm happy Firebrand's won.
Yeah, what I'm going to do championship-wise, let the titles go round a few times, then maybe have someone be like a two-time champion.
Yeah, that's a fair thing. Let other people weigh the looking first. If they've worked their way up the rankings, then becoming a two-time champion's really a bonus.
Mm, yeah, absolutely. It can be done fairly. Four. Okay, yep, absolutely. On to the main event of the evening.
I quite agree with you, Miranda 1935. He is a prayer.
That is awesome. So, we're on to the main event of the evening already. It is a shorter show this week because with the season, no, not season, with the Go Home show next week, heading from Nashville, Tennessee. Bianca Belair, who won the women's.
Are you a wrestler yourself, Red T4?
And hailing from Osaka, Japan, Asuka with her manager. Also hailing from Osaka, Japan, Kairi Sane. Asuka used to be called Kana and she used to be a model many, many, many moons ago. So without further ado, I'm bringing the action to everyone. That, I know we can't go to wrestling shows at the moment, which sucks, but you know, it will have to do. So we currently have 7 people live with us on stream. Welcome everyone, hope you're doing well. If anyone...
Me and Blue Boy 1985 booked a great super show, which you can check on demand on YouTube.
Nice, Lou Fez Press from Asuka. Followed by the mounted punches. Let them fight, ref. How dare you? Break the fight up again and you'll be fired, chief. So who's winning?
I do hope the next game allows you to create what cutscenes you want to see as well. If you want an ambush backstage, you can do an ambush.
Yeah, they're fucking stupid. Nice. Slingshot. Vertical suplex.
say the airbrush thing would work as well. Say you want to book a monster, you can have them just airbrush people or destroy people.
Yeah, because Visual Concepts fucking took that bit out. Yeah, you used to be able to do that. Nice shoulder breaker from Bianca Belair. Asuka or Bianca Belair?
I'm going to rant a little bit on Visual Concepts myself. Murray is not fucking rude.
Yeah, Scandinavian for... Because I have done some research. It's Scandinavian for sailor, so... If he is Scandinavian... I have checked. People from Iceland can be Vikings. One. Only enough for a 1 pound. Yeah, sure. Just tell me what you need me to do, and basically, I have your Visual Concepts are a fucking arse monk, like fucking hell. But 2K have to do as they're told. I don't think it's fair Uke's got taken out because they knew what they were fucking doing. I hope this AEW game does well. It's from the makers of Virtual Pro Wrestling and No Mercy on the N64, former THQ people. So if this match, I think this match is happening in real life, isn't it? At Mania.
Yeah.
Is it? Do we know if it? Is it?
I think isn't it Bianca and Sasha?
One of the fuck. I knew I'd get it wrong. Yeah, I think so. I knew it's one of the fucking two.
I know there was. I know that. Well, obviously, the thing with Asuka, that main event almost the win that. That
like
main event for her title almost
ended up in
jeopardy because after Asuka got hit in the face.
Yeah, oh that was. Oh yeah, oh that was. Yeah, that was nasty. I was like,
who stiffed Asuka in the end?
I think it. I don't want to guess. I know it's some donkey. I'm quite surprised.
I think it was Shayna.
Shayna Baszler. I'm quite surprised Bianca Belair hasn't fell over from having such a big fucking ponytail. Nice. Elevated alley-oop. Powerbomb.
They're bound to do that at some point as an angle because of how long her hair is. They'll probably do a hair angle with that at some point.
Bianca Belair. With the torture rack.
I keep forgetting what member of the Street Profits she's married to.
I think it's Montez Ford.
The only problem with MSK, like that sequence, like they used Xavier and Nashgara, I think they are too much like the Street Profits.
Yeah, pretty much. At least Asuka.
Still does make me laugh though.
Go for the pin. One, two. Only enough for a 2 count. The butt bump doesn't do it this week. Or the arse bump. One of the two. I never.
Yeah, it does make me laugh, mate, who like created the name Wesley.
They probably went in like a random generator. A nice cross faced chicken ring. Followed by a nicely executed body scissors.
If I was
in creating,
I'd have come up with the
name Wesley Xavier.
Oh, Xavier Wesley? Yeah.
Wonderful.
I have heard, mate, Asuka is a bit of a Looney Tune behind the scenes. She really is weird.
I don't want to say anything, just in case. I will be doing that later on, so... Let's see what our rankings are for this week. So... Got edit the division for 2 seconds. We will be doing the top 10... No, top... 12 challenges. 12th seed is Billy Kay. 11th seed is Dana Brooks. 10th seed is Carmella. Earthbrand is 9th. Firebrand has gone up to 8th. Nikki Cross is 7th seed. 6th seed, Dakota Kai. 5th seed, going up, is Asuka. 4th seed is Walter Brand. 3rd seed is The Saint 2. Bianca Belair is the number 2 seed. And the number 1 contender for the Queen of Valor Championship to face Alexa Bliss at the season finale, if it stays the same, the same. And we're doing the top 10 for Cesaro's Ring of Valor Championship. In 10th seed is South Africa's Angelico. In 9th seed with the win and going up, Ace Austin. 8th seed, Jordan Oliver. 7th seed, Noir. 6th seed, Chad Gable. 6th seed, Cedric Alexander. 4th seed, Apollo Crews. 3rd seed, Big E. The 2nd seed, Void. And number 1 contender. And 1st seed, Sheamus. Let's see where. Well, 2 people that basically need to break the top 10 is Champagne Charlie, Warhorse, Biff Bulick, Dragon Slayer, Eddie Kingston, Owen Murray, Kyle O'Reilly, LeBron Kendrick, Necro Butcher, The Blade, Firewalker, Leo Rush, Willie Mack, Brian Cage, Lucas Jackson, Aleister Black. Thank you very much for watching. You've been a fantastic audience. And I want you to do 3 things. 1, look after yourself. 2, look after the relatives, elder relatives, and the animals you might have. And 3, please wear a face mask to protect yourself and others. If you can't, due to medical or basically that was considered sexually orientated, so I don't basically want anyone slipping themselves up, so don't be an arse. Peace out, God bless. And I will be back tomorrow for more streaming content goodness. Thank you and good night for now.